mattress number to the number on your table. Hi, mattress number to the number on your table. Welcome. All right, thank you for going straight to your desk, everyone. Here you go. On the first day of school, to assign students a seat, I give them an index card with a number on it. And so now they need to walk in and match that number to their desk. And so I do that to show them that it's not a free-for-all. There is structure. As soon as they walk in, there is structure in the room, and they do have an assigned desk. So our learning intention for the week is that we're getting familiar with expectations. So we're learning our class expectations, and we're getting to know the people in our learning community. My goal for students on the first week of school is to create a comfortable environment, a friendly environment where they feel comfortable in. So I really focus on PBIS and making sure that they establish a sense of community in my classroom. I believe in this room we are a community right now because we have at least one common goal, which is to pass this class, right? We have that goal. It is my goal to help you. So that's a common goal we have. So it already makes us a community. But we can be a stronger community if we get to know each other's values or attitudes and each other's interests. The first community building activity was for them to create a name tent. And so that was actually their due now as soon as they walked in. They put a common interest on the back of the name tent. And so that was their first community building activity, was for them to share that. And I do that in a very structured way. Their seats are not just numbered with their seat number, but they actually have a number 1 through 4. And so I'm able to control who goes first. I'm able to say, okay, number 2 goes first, and then it's number 3's turn. And so that encourages all students to speak, and they also keep each other accountable because they can see the number and they can share, okay, it's your turn.
One of my hobbies is usually going outside and playing with my dogs or playing softball. I went to J2 Middle School.
On my free time, I like to play Elden Ring, and the middle school I went to is Curtis Middle.
To teach procedures, I don't teach them all in one period. I intertwine them throughout the week. And so the very first procedure is how to enter the classroom. And so they walk in the first day, and then that's the first thing I tell them is, how do we enter the classroom? And I also talk about how we exit the classroom, and I let them know that we'll practice it at the end of the period. And so we continue all week. I keep reminding them, and we continue to practice.
And if you feel ready, your area is clean, your floor is clean, your materials are put away, you may stand behind your chair, push your chair in. So as soon as the bell rings, you are free to go. Tomorrow we'll talk a little bit more about the syllabus. All right, see you guys tomorrow. I hope you had a wonderful first day. Good afternoon. Don't forget your name tents, everyone. Hi, how are you today?
Good,
good. Hi, welcome back. Come on in. Hi, guys. How are you today? All right, good. Now I see 100% of you with a paper. So on the paper, I want you to write 2 truths and 1 lie about yourself. So I gave you an example. The example is about me. So for example, there's 3 statements up here. One of them is a lie, okay? So I said that I have 3 kids, I met Snoop Dogg at Applebee's, and I've lived in Spain.
For the second day, the community building activity was 2 truths and a lie. And that's always a fun day for students to be creative because they have to come up with a lie of their own. And it's also a fun day for me to share something fun about myself. And so it helps them to see that I'm human. It helps, and it also gets them to have a little bit of fun as they try to guess what the lie is.
I hear you guys being so analytical. Like, why would Snoop Dogg be at Applebee's, right? Okay, so this is a science class. So I always have evidence. And I have evidence that I met Snoop Dogg at Applebee's. So, let me tell you the story.
By spreading out community building throughout the first week, I think it really it builds a stronger community. By having it just one day, I think the next day the students may come in and forget what we did the previous day. And that sense of community is not being built. It takes time to build a strong community. So that's why for me it's important to take the entire first week and build the community.
I think that you did 2 years in school in Mexico is a lie. That's true? Wow. What years were they?
Fourth and fifth.
Fourth and fifth. Is it different? Yeah? How different? What's the one thing you remember?
Good afternoon. Hi, I love your earrings. They're so cute. Good afternoon.
I was saving this for next week, but I think you are all ready. Okay. So far you've done community circles with your peers at your table. I want you to meet people from other tables. I think you're ready to expand your little community. So that's what we're gonna try today. So you will be sharing three things from your interest survey with someone from a different table. Here is how. I will play music. So on the third day, I had the students answer an interest survey, as they're due now. And they used that interest survey to then find a partner around the room. So this time it was someone else other than at their table. So it was nice for them to expand their community. It wasn't just their table. So then they met someone new or others around the room. And they were able to share three things about themselves. And again, our goal, I told them, was to build community and to learn common interests from everyone in the room.
Last period of the day, you made it. We're almost done with our first week.
Huh?
We're almost done with our first week. Can you believe it?
No.
It went by fast, huh? Hi, welcome.
I think it's important for a teacher to be at the door greeting our students because we're introducing ourselves the first week of school. And so I always want my students to find me approachable. So I'm always friendly at the door. And then I also get to know them. I do my best to learn names and greet them by their first name. So that's practice for me. And then it also helps me start kind of reminding them of the expectations and the procedures as they're coming in. I remind them to put their phones away or take off their hats. And so that establishes our classroom norms even before they walk in the door.
Hold on. Make sure you end your conversation real quick and then you can come in. There you go. These are the expectations as your teacher that I have for you. Okay, this is what my perspective, what I expect from you. So to be respectful, please make sure you're using academic language because we're all professionals. As your teacher, I'm a professional. I'm an educator. I'm here to help you learn. And your full-time job is to be a student. So be a professional student and use that academic language. Remember to maintain a positive attitude throughout the learning process. Chemistry is not easy. Okay, just being transparent with you guys. It can be difficult, but we're gonna maintain a positive attitude when it gets challenging. Now let's talk about you and what you want for each other. So you already underlined 10 values. I want you to look at those 10 values, just those. Don't look at all the other ones. Of those 10, I want you to circle 5 that are most important to you. So I should see 5 circles on your paper. So of those 10, circle 5. Okay. Out of those 5, okay, so now just look at those 5 you circled. I want you to put a star next to your top 3. I know it gets harder. You're narrowing it down. Put a star next to those top 3. On Google Classroom, you have 2 new things on here. I want you to click on the one that says Mentimeter, and there will be a link. That link, when you open it, it's gonna ask you to enter your 3 core values. Okay, those top 3. You're gonna enter them and submit, okay? As your words come in, they start to propagate this word cloud. And the words that we most agree on are larger in size or larger font. And so the ones we most agree on so far are what?
Honesty.
Honesty. Trust.
Loyalty.
Loyalty. I see love for family.
So to make my social contract focused, I used our school-wide expectations, our be respectful, be responsible, and be safe. And so I used that as an outline. I asked the students, how are you respectful? How will you be safe? And how will you be responsible? And so it was very structured. And so they got to brainstorm their own ideas. From there, they got to speak to their community at their table and decide on one. And then as a whole community, as a class, they got to do a class vote. And so that way they have ownership on the expectations that they built for their class period. Let's see what the last one was. Be prepared for everything and own up to your mistakes. I like that. I will practice that too. I will own up to any mistakes. If I make a mistake, I will make sure to address it. Coming on in. Hi, welcome. Don't forget to take off your hat. Thank you for taking it off. Hi, welcome back. It's nice and fresh inside. To wrap up the week in our last community building was a Quizlet. And so what's really neat about Quizlet is that it randomizes teams and it is very competitive. It forces the students to speak to each other. So even if it's someone they haven't met already, they start to work together and they have that common goal of winning. So that is some community building. And rather than having them take a quiz on the procedures or, you know, take additional notes on procedures, it's a neat way for them to review before we get started for the next week.
Material, sharpened pencils, when appropriate, like when she's talking, like do it after she finishes so you don't disrupt her.
You only get 6 mortgage passes per semester.
Chemistry is notoriously known for being a very difficult subject. So by building community and helping my students feel safe and helping them feel like they can rely on each other and create a teamwork environment, it really helps them bring that self-efficacy so that when it does get challenging, they are okay asking questions and they know it's okay to ask questions and we're in this together and we're learning together.